From the following particulars, calculate assessable value and total customs duty payable. Date of presentation of bill of entry 26, date of arrival of the aircraft 36. We need to take whichever is later for determining the rate. So therefore the rate is 10%, correct? And what is the exchange rate here? Interbank exchange rate is there, notified by CBEC is there. You need to take notified by CBEC prevailing on which date? Bill of entry, that is 62. And IGST is 12%. So now we need to calculate CIF value $2,000, air freight $500, insurance cost is $100, landing charges not ascertainable. First, CIF value directly given, we cannot take that way because we need to first ascertain the FOB value. Why we need to ascertain the FOB value? We need to compare air freight actual or 20% of FOB, whichever is lower for that reason. So calculate the FOB value. 2000 minus 500 minus 100, that is 1400. 1400 is the FOB value, correct? Add air freight, no adjustments to FOB value. Please check the question, there is no adjustments to the FOB value. Add air freight. Air freight actual how much here? 500, 20% of FOB, that is 1400 into 20%, 280, whichever is lower, that is 280, you understood? Then insurance directly given, how much is that insurance? $100, actuals we will take. Now 1780 is the CIF price, good. And we need to take the exchange rate. What is the exchange rate here? 62. So when you take 62, you will get 1,10,360. That is the assessable value. Thereafter, can you do this customs duty computation?
Yes, sir.
Come on, quick. 1,10,360 is the assessable value. Then basic customs duty, 11,036. 10%, na? On that social welfare surcharge, 1,103.6. Sir, the last number you round off to the nearest 1 rupee, sir. The last number you round off to the nearest 1 rupee. Intermediate calculations don't round off. Clear, pa? And if you add this, you will be getting 12,139.60. Now, IGST we need to calculate by taking assessable value 1,10,360 plus 12,139.60 into 12%. Sir, still I have given ECSHEC, that is social welfare surcharge. Wherever ECSHEC comes, you change it to social welfare surcharge. How much it is? 14,700. Don't round off. 699.95. Now the total is there, na, that you round off. That the total you need to round off, rounded off. How much? 26,840. Sir, while doing customs duty computation, remember, don't round off the intermediate calculations. Round off the final value. Clear or not? Don't round off the intermediate calculation, round off the final value. Then, sir, how much IGST I will pay at the time when I pay IGST separately? If I pay IGST separately, I am not going to pay the IGST separately. I will put this data in the bill of entry. In bill of entry, we will put 0.2 digits in the bill of entry. You understood or not? So, in bill of entry also, we will be exactly mentioning and final number only we will do round off. That's why follow it in exam also. Okay? Then, with this, we completed valuation. Look into the next topic. Sir, all study material questions I discuss, sir. And past exam questions on valuation will be of this range. But I told you, like there are certain areas which has not been touched by ICAI, like that valuation rules, identical goods, similar goods. So those areas, they have not yet touched. Chances of asking questions on those areas are high. Okay, because this they have exhausted, repeatedly they gave and they have exhausted. So now from last attempt onwards, they started asking in the valuation rules, deductive value they have asked. So maybe this time identical goods possible. Okay, please look out for that information carefully before going to the exam hall. Okay, because we did what adjustments to be made on that also questions can be framed, possible. possible. Now look into the next area. We will see duty drawback. Have a look into that. Segment 28, duty drawback. What is duty drawback here? I told you it is an incentive available. When that incentive is available, whenever I export, whenever I import some goods used in manufacture of finished goods, or if I export it as such, I will be getting duty drawback. Duty drawback is available in three situations. Please listen. First, you are importing one robot. You are importing one robot for display in an exhibition. Once that exhibition is over, you are exporting that robot back. What happened here? You imported some goods and you have exported it as such. Correct? You imported the goods and you exported it as such. With use or without use? Without use. Just you displayed it. That is not called as use. You have not used it. So imported it, exported it as such, or a different product as such. With use or without use? Without use. That is situation one. Situation two, you have imported some racing cars to conduct a Formula One race here. You conducted the race and once the race is over, you sent those cars back. Now this is which situation? You have imported the goods and you exported it as such, or after, like as such, or a different product as such, but after use. Is it clear or not? What is the first situation? That robot example, you imported the goods, you exported it as such without use. Second example, that racing cars example, is what? You have imported the goods and you have exported it as such after use. Correct? Now, third example, say you wanted to manufacture some smartphones. For that smartphones, you need the hardware, na? You wanted to start smartphone manufacturing in India. For that, you wanted to create your own technology. You don't want Android or iOS, because already badly there is a need of a different technology. So you wanted to develop some different technology, and hardware you wanted to import. So import and manufacture. What you import? Raw material. You import raw material, manufacture FG, and then export. Clear, pa? Now, in this case also, what is happening? You have imported some goods, converted it into different product, and then you have exported. So, in these three situations, we get duty drawback. Clear or not? What are the three situations? Can you explain me three examples I told you? First is robot example. Situation explain. Imported goods, exported as such without use. Good. Second, that racing cars. Imported goods, exported as such after use. Third example, that smartphones. Imported goods used in manufacture of finished goods and then exported. Clear, pa? Now, situation 1 and situation 2 is in section 74. Situation 3 is in section 75. So, we have two sections related to duty drawback. Section 74 and section 75. Section 74 is for first two situations. Clear or not? Imported goods, exported as such, with use or without use. And imported goods converted into finished goods and then exported is 75. In this 74 also, first situation, imported goods exported as such without use is 74 subsection 1. Clear, pa? Imported goods exported as such without use is 74 subsection 1. Imported goods exported after use, as such only, but after use is 74 subsection 2. That data I have given there in a table, in a chart. Have a look into that. So basically duty drawback is what? Refund. Basically duty drawback is what? Refund. Refund. Okay? Refund only. But that refund has got a name. That name is duty drawback. Understood? So, how it will be given to you, sir? Like credit, huh? Like credit, which can be adjusted against the future liabilities, not that way. This duty drawback is money that is credited into your account. Means it is like refund only, na? So, therefore, it is like refund. And these are the three situations which I have discussed. You understood? Clear, yeah? Now, Let's start with 74 first. First we will complete 74 and then we will see 75. But for comparison purpose, I gave it together. While discussing, I am discussing independently 74 and independently 75. 74 is what? Imported goods exported as such. As such. In this case, you will be getting duty drawback provided the exported product and imported product is same. If you have changed its identity, you will not get duty drawback under 74, correct? Which means whether you need to prove the identity of the exported goods and imported goods are same. Yes, look into when admissible. Look into when admissible. Imported goods are re-exported as it is or after use, and the article is easily identifiable. Underline that. Easily identifiable to the satisfaction of ACDC. Easily identifiable to the satisfaction of ACDC. Assistant Commissioner, Deputy Commissioner of Customs. Of Customs. Then, we have rules in this regard. We have rules in this regard. For 74 purpose, we have rules. And that rules is Duty Drawback Rules 1995. Re-export of imported goods rules 1995, or in simple words you can remember it as duty drawback rules 1995. Okay, so lot of information we don't have in the act itself. Act has only basic information, but information regarding what is the form in which we need to apply or how much duty drawback we'll get, restrictions, everything is in rules. Which rules here? Duty drawback rules 1995. So far we discussed some rules in customs. What is that? Customs valuation rules 2007 for the purpose of that valuation. It is DCR, correct? Same way for import also, customs valuation rules 2007. For export also we have rules na? Comparison method, computed method, residual method. So that is also in customs valuation rules 2007. Now the second set of rules that we are discussing now is duty drawback rules 1995. For which section here? 74. Now what is the first condition that we have learned? It should be easily identifiable to the satisfaction of ACDC. And how it should be exported means what is the mode or when it is treated as export. What is the general meaning of export that you know? Taking goods to a place outside India. That's the first point. That's the first point. Second, supply to SEZ is also considered as export for the purpose of duty drawback. Is it clear? Supply to SEZ is also considered as export for the purpose of duty drawback. When you export, how you get benefit? The same way when you supply it to SEZ also, you will get the benefit. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Then third, supply of stores to foreign going vessel or aircraft. What is this? Sir, there is a foreign going aircraft or a foreign going vessel. To that foreign going aircraft or vessel, you are supplying some goods. Sir, where is it foreign going vessel or aircraft in India? Where is that foreign going vessel or aircraft in India? To such a foreign going vessel or aircraft, you are supplying some goods. Example, pa, ATF is imported by a oil refinery. Say IOC imports ATF, pa, aviation turbine fuel. On that import of ATF, they need to pay customs duty, na? And this ATF is supplied to a foreign going aircraft. Now it is treated as export for them. So can they get duty drawback, sir? Yes. Are you getting this? They can get duty drawback because they are supplying it to a foreign going aircraft. Next, there is a vessel. That vessel needs some lifeboats for the purpose of, like in case of any contingency, the crew has to use the lifeboats and life jackets and they need to swim and come. For that purpose, you supplied some lifeboats and life jackets which are imported. You imported lifeboats, life jackets, and you are selling it to a ship. Is it clear here? What ship it is? Foreign going ship. Now it is called as export for you. Whatever customs duty paid on import, you will get it as a refund. Is it clear or not? So export does not mean, for the purpose of 74, export does not mean taking it to outside India. Even if I supply it to SEZ or if I supply it to a foreign going vessel or aircraft, it is treated as export. Is it clear? What is a foreign going vessel or aircraft? That vessel or aircraft which is transporting goods or passengers from India to a place outside India is known as foreign going vessel or aircraft. Clear here? Then, related rules already we discussed, na? Examples. Imports for exhibition, we discussed. Robot example, okay? Goods rejected or wrong shipment, that is also same. Imported goods, wrong shipment, quality difference, or goods are different. You exported, imported goods, exported, as such without use. Can we get it under 74? Yes. Excess shipment, we ordered 10,000 tons. They sent 20,000 tons. Excess shipment, what we can do? So we will return. So that is also eligible for this duty drawback? Yes. And then, but remember, without importing, if you export, you have not paid customs duty at all. Then when it will come? Only when you import and then export. Is it clear? But I told you, there is a simple way. You don't have to pay customs duty also. Keep it in the warehouse and from there itself you send. You don't have to pay any customs duty and no need to bother about refund. So when this will arise, you imported, taken it outside the customs barrier and then you are exporting. In that case, you will be getting refund of the customs duty paid on import. Understood? Then, what is the time limit within which the export should take place? Within 2 years from the date of payment of import duty, not 2 years from the date of import. What does it mean? It means that, sir, I am importing on one date, but I am paying the customs duty related to that imported goods at a later date. Example, I kept the goods in warehouse. Correct? I kept the goods in warehouse. When I will pay customs duty? Only when I clear it from the warehouse. Now this 2 years should be counted from when? From the day I pay the customs duty. Not from the date when I file bill of entry or import, etc. Is it clear? Yes, plus, it can be further extended for a period by CBIC. Okay? It can be further extended. Not 2 years is always the time, it can be further extended. But you know what is a very important point? In exam, you will get confused. You will count it from the date of import. Don't count it from the date of import. From the date when you have made the payment of customs duty. Look into footnote 2, not the date of import. Look into the footnote number 2, not the date of import. Also, if duty is paid on provisional basis, the date of payment of provisional duty is relevant. Understood? Then, next. Sir, what is the meaning of exported? Sorry, 2 years starting date, you know. What is the starting date? The date when you pay duty. What is the ending date? When it is exported. What is the meaning of export there? Let export order. Please see footnote number 1. What is the meaning of export? Let export order. So therefore, from the date when you pay customs duty to the let export order, the time limit should be within 2 years. Or it can be extended for a further period. Then, coverage of duty. Listen here, listen. Sir, at the time of import, what is it you are paying? What is it you are paying at the time of import? BCD. Then, social welfare surcharge, IGST. Tell. Additional customs duty. What is that? Safeguard duty, anti-subsidy duty, anti-dumping duty. When I say IGST, even GST compensation says, correct? Huh? Then, all these are eligible for refund. Even IGST. All these are eligible for refund, even IGST. That's the bloody reason why at the time when we discussed refund of ITC, I told if you have claimed duty drawback, you will not get refund of ITC. Because first you did not take it as a ITC. You are claiming refund. Is it clear? You cannot enjoy two benefits. Because what usually you will do, this IGST will take as ITC na? Innappa, this IGST will take as ITC na? If you take it as ITC, then duty drawback you can claim. Duty drawback you can claim. They will not check. But when GST department comes to know that you claimed duty drawback on this IGST component, they will ask you to reverse the ITC. Is it clear? Say this. Customs duties including social welfare surcharge as well as IGST are refunded. What about additional customs duties? Everything will be refunded. Clear or not? How much, sir? 100% they will refund us, sir? No, not 100%. Please see the next point. 98%. How much they will refund, pa? 98%, not 100%, only 98%. Appa 2% loss, clear? The 2% is loss and time value of money is also loss. You pay now, but you get the refund at a later point of time, with interest or without interest? Without interest. What is this? Giving that 98% itself is too much. Eh? In that you expect interest also? No. So that interest is a loss to you, time value of money. Then next, even this 2%, you will not get 100%. Is it clear? That's where I advised that rather than importing the goods and paying customs duty, if you have planned to export, keep it in the warehouse. The 2% also you will save. Clear? Then, this is in case of 74 subsection 1. What is 74 subsection 1? Sir? Imported goods exported as such without use. Now, what if goods are imported and exported after use? After use, then duty drawback at reduced rates. Look into page number 21.6 related to that. Sorry, 28.5, change that page number reference here, 28.5, look into page 28.5, duty drawback at reduced rates, sir. Sir, in which case duty drawback at reduced rates? Imported goods exported as such after use. Now, what is that reduced rates? Please listen. 98% in case of 74 subsection 1, correct? In case of 74 subsection 2, imported goods are divided into 2. In case of 74 subsection 2, imported goods are divided into 2. Motor vehicles imported by any person and goods imported for personal use. Clear pa? Imported goods are divided into 2 for the purpose of which section? 74 subsection 2. What is 74 subsection 2? Imported goods are exported as such after use. Now, first category is what? Either motor vehicle imported by any person. Second category is what? Any goods imported for what purpose? Personal purpose. Now, how the duty drawback is given? Please see. If you are using it for first year, if you are using it for first year, 4% for every quarter or part thereof, which means if you use it for full 1 year, how much will be deducted? 16%. Up, how much will be the duty drawback? 100 minus 16. You understood, huh? Then you are using it for the second year, how much will be the percentage? It is like we discussed 2.5% for every quarter or part thereof in GST. Do you remember? Same way, but it is not flat 2.5% for every quarter or part thereof. It is going like a WDV model. First year means higher deduction. Second year means lesser. So first year, every quarter 4%. Second year, every quarter 3%. So which means if you use it for 2 years, for first year 16% gone. For second year? 12%. So 16 plus 12, 28. Then how much will be the refund? 72% you will get as a refund. Clear or not? Then next part, 2.5% for every quarter in the third year. Suppose if you use it for 3 years, 28 plus 10, 38%. Correct? Huh? Then what will be the refund? 62%. Then if you are using it for fourth year also, 2% for every quarter means 8%. So 38 plus 8, 46. And what will be the refund that you will get? 54%. Thereafter, if you use, sir, after 4 years you are using, sir, nothing you will get. No duty drawback. Clear, pa? No duty drawback. Which means goods should have been exported within? 4 years. Actually, initial time itself is 2 years. But that extra 2 years also based on extension. Clear or not? Thereafter, if you export and all, you will not get any duty drawback. Look into that paragraph. Where such motor vehicles or goods imported for personal use are exported after the expiry of 2 years, the duty drawback would be allowed only if the CBEC extends. No duty drawback shall be allowed if those goods have been used for more than 4 years. Understood? Then, second goods, that is other than this. What is other than this means? motor vehicles, come on, motor vehicles imported by any person, then other goods imported for personal purpose, by whom? By an individual only, by an individual, correct? Other goods imported for personal purpose by an individual, but motor vehicle that can be imported for any purpose, correct? And that can be imported by any person. So second category, in the second category it is like, depending upon the time period, a flat rate is given. You increase every slab by 3 months, 0 to 3, 3 to 6, 6 to 9, 9 to 12. Like that you increase the every slab by 3 months up to 18 months. Increase the every slab by 3 months up to 18 months. And it starts with 95%. And with every slab, it reduces by 10% up to 75%. It starts with 95%. For every slab, it reduces by 10% up to 75%. Thereafter, it reduces by 5%. After 18 months, you will not get any duty drawback. Clear or not? Can you remember it this way?
Yes, sir.
How, sir? First, you increase the slab by 3 months. So 0 to 3, 3 to 6, 6 to 9, like that you have to make up to 18 months. After 18 months, you will not get any duty drawback. And what is the percentage of duty drawback? It starts with 95. For every slab, it will come down by 10% up to 75. Thereafter, it comes down by 5%. Beyond 18 months, you will not get any duty drawback. So this rates you have to remember. Because in question when they give, they will not give this rate. You need to do the computation and tell how much is the duty drawback. Are you getting this? For that reason, you need to remember this rates. Are you getting this? Sir, these rates are for situation 1 or situation 2? What was situation 2? Imported goods exported as such after use. As such after use. Suppose if it is imported goods exported as such without use, flat 98%. Now look into realization of forex. There is no condition as to realization of forex. Wow, what a super provision, which means I can receive in Indian rupees also, correct? I can receive in Indian rupees. So there is no condition as to forex, then also I am getting duty drawback. Is it clear? Yeah. Then in case of 75 only it is there, not in case of 74. So in case of 74, there is no condition as to realization of forex. Still I will be getting incentive, clear or not? And mandatory prohibition. There are few prohibitions here. Duty drawback less than 50. Maybe they don't know the currency, not 50 rupees. They don't know. And no, less than 50 means why we also will go. Why we also will go? It's okay, some donation made to the government, like that we will think. Correct, Appa? And it is like that maybe you imported one tie, you returned that tie. That tie could be somewhere 200 rupees. Okay, Papa. On the 200 rupees, the customs duty could have been somewhere 60 rupees. But 60 rupees, 98%, will you claim and all? No, nah. So even if you claim, they are telling, even if you claim, we will not give if it is less than 50. But why we will claim if it is less than 50? Sir, is it a print mistake that instead of giving 50,000, they gave 50? No, no. It is not print mistake. It is 50 only. It is 50 only. But long back it was made, 1995. And even today they have made it as 50 only. That's the problem. You understood or not? Then, market price of export goods is less than duty drawback. What is this? What is this here? Market price of export goods is less than duty drawback. Yeah, duty drawback is what here? A percentage of customs duty. A percentage of customs duty. But the market value of export goods is less than the duty drawback, means the value of the goods should have come down pathetically at a lower level. Correct? Look into this question. Value of imported goods is 1 lakh. Customs duty paid on import is say 30%, 30,000. Exported as such without use after 18 months. After 18 months, it is exported as such without use. Can it be exported?
Yes.
Will there be any duty drawback? No, sir. After 18 months, no, sir. That is 74 subsection 2. It is 74 subsection 1. 74 subsection 1, you can export it within 2 years. and therefore you can export it after 18 months. But after 18 months, definitely the market value will get affected. Sir, market value of any product you take today and 1.5 year before, electronics, because other goods market value will increase, but electronics market value, no, it will never be. Because, you know, this technology gets changed like anything. So robust it is. And ACR, you take ACR, 1.5 year before purchased AC, today if you are selling, you might be purchasing at 40,000 rupees, 50,000 rupees, but when you are selling, they will ask, okay, 5,000 we will pay, illa 10,000 we will pay. Why? A change in technology. Now inverter ACs have come. You understood? Power consumption has come down, noise has come down, and with lot of latest technology, we are going. So electronics, even though you have not used, it's a new product. Is it clear or not? You know, Nokia N95, you know?
Yes, sir.
Correct. You know or learned now? In your childhood, you would have seen. That's a dream of every kid that when we grow up, we need to buy this. Now it is available. Buy now at same rate. Same rate. At that time itself, it was 45,000 rupees, 50,000 rupees. And buy now, now. For 1,000 rupees, it is available. Yes, it is available. It is available at 1,000 rupees. New one. Yes, it is available. What is the purpose of using it? Because it is a basic mobile. How much ever advanced it may be, it's a basic mobile today. Is it clear or not? Like the technology changes. So in that case, the market value will come down. See the market value. Market value of such goods have come down to 20,000. Whether duty drawback is available. What is the percentage of duty drawback? 30,000 into 98%, 29,400. But its market value itself is 20,000. No duty drawback, because the market value of exported goods is less than the duty drawback. Understood? Can you tell me the two prohibitions here? Come on, first one. DBK less than. The short form of duty drawback is DBK. DBK less than 50, you will not get. If market value of the goods is less than the amount of duty drawback, then also you will not get. Then, export goods are different from the imported goods. Identity test you need to satisfy, na? What if you are not satisfying the identity test? Then you will not get duty drawback. Understood? Then, look into next. This is one question not related to 74, 75. When we come there, we'll see. Discretionary prohibition. So far what we have seen is mandatory prohibition. Now discretionary prohibition. Central government may notify that no DBK shall be admissible if any goods which post-export are likely to be smuggled back into India. Underline that. Post-export are likely to be smuggled back into India. It is like, listen, pa, I am importing some goods from Japan. And these goods are chargeable to customs duty. Let's take this Sony TV is there, na? Sony TV. Sony Bravia, okay? And that TV I am importing. And there is customs duty on that. But I wanted to sell in India without the customs duty. Because if customs duty, with customs duty I need to sell, na? The price will be touching somewhere 80,000, 90,000 and all. I don't want to sell with customs duty. Without customs duty means it can be sold at 50,000 rupees or 60,000 rupees. Therefore, I want to sell it without customs duty. But I cannot do the smuggling. Then, this is a better way. I will import and in paper, I will say that it is exported to Nepal or it is exported to Sri Lanka. Is it clear? In paper, I will show that it is exported to Nepal and thereafter, from there, it can be smuggled back to India. Is it clear here? Understood. Suppose if they open and see also, really I may send the goods. Either in paper I can do or really also I can do. If I do in paper, they cannot do anything. This prohibition is not applicable. Why this prohibition is not applicable? Because really goods went, pa? No, goods did not go. So therefore that loophole is still there. What is that loophole? Import, pay customs duty and you say that it has been exported to Sri Lanka. Is it clear? But the product is in India. Then what you have exported? What you have exported? Some stones you have exported. Clear? Some slabs are there, na? Granite slab or stone that you are exporting. Okay, va? You are exporting that. And the TV is there. You can sell it here. 98% of the customs duty paid, you got as duty drawback. You understood? And what government can do? They can't do anything. That loophole is still there. Another loophole. Actually, I may send it and I may bring it back. In that case, they are telling when they have a doubt, they may not give the duty drawback. Is it clear or not? Central government may notify that no duty drawback shall be admissible if any goods which post-export are likely to be smuggled back to India. So mainly in case of landlocked countries or nearest countries when it is being exported, it is possible to bring it back to India. So they may not allow. See, it's not compulsory here. It is central government by notification will be doing it. So it's not always compulsory. Identity satisfaction should be established or not? Yes. What is the procedure for claiming duty drawback? Duty drawback claim shall be filed manually. There is a form. Manually we need to file that form within 3 months, and an extension of 3 months is given by ACDC and an extension of 6 months is given by commissioner. From when, sir? From the date of let export order. Sir, what is the process in getting the refund? There is a duty drawback form for the purpose of 74. That form we need to file manually, no online form, it is manual form. And within 3 months, and can it be extended for a further period? Yes, plus three by whom? ACDC, plus 6 months by commissioner. This should be counted from when? Let export order. Once it is filed, duty drawback form is filed, claim is filed, within 1 month, they will give duty drawback. If they are not giving, they are going to pay interest after 1 month. In GST also we had 60 days. Correct, Appa? Here it is duty drawback case, it is 1 month. Within 1 month they will give, otherwise they will pay interest. And what is the rate of interest? 6% per annum. Understood here? This is about the procedure. Now, 74, we are still in 74. Look into below. Non-availability of duty drawback. 74 subsection 2 benefit is not applicable in case of wearing apparel and T-chest. 74 subsection 2. Appa 74 subsection 1 is applicable, sir. Yes. Now listen. Generally, you know, this youth today is having lot of craze towards the garments which the celebrities are wearing. Celebrities for functions in movies and all, they wear some garments. Na? That garments, listen here. That garments, today Instagram, if you see, they will be posting. So this shirt the celebrity is wearing, which is of some 12,000 rupees, which is of some 18,000 rupees, like that they will be mentioning. And these are not Indian brands. These are of foreign brands. And with the advent of today credit cards are available with everyone and payment gateways will take care. So we can shop it in the foreign websites. Lot of foreign websites, we can do the shopping and we will place the order. We will make the payment through the payment gateways and the product will come. But when the product reaches us, maybe this size what we have ordered may not fit to us. It may be too large or it may be too short. Then what you will do, you will send it back. Clear, pa? And for celebrity it is okay, but for me it should be okay or not. Only when I wear I will know, correct or not. Enna, pa? So lot of times when you shop in Myntra, Flipkart, etc., buy any garments, for that person who is wearing it will be good. For us only it won't be good, correct? And so when we are importing it and we did not like it, we are sending it back to outside India. Can we get duty drawback? Yes. Yes, we can get duty drawback because that is 74 subsection 1. Now, you wear it, you went to the function over, thereafter what is the use of it? Pack it and then send it. Will you get duty drawback? No, because you have exported it after use. What is the criteria, sir? Simple. Every person will ask for tag. If you are not cutting the tags, that garment will have tag, na? If you are not cutting the tag and if you send it, it is called as exported it as such without use. Sir, here, how it will be made, sir? On the basis of declaration only, pa. Sir, will they open and see, sir? No, declaration. It is a declaration. But suppose if they open and see, at that time they will reject and they will levy penalty. So it is based on declaration. Exported it after use, will you get any duty drawback, pa? No, you will not get any duty drawback. Then, so because this I came to know, because the so-called great people who I know, they will be purchasing from Myntra 30 days return policy. They will wear, they will be going to the function and tag and all, they will keep it on the back side. It won't be visible, intact, everything will be intact. And they will wear it and thereafter they will fold it and they will send it back. Their money they will be getting. 30 days return policy, you understood or not? Intelligent, basically anything like that and all we should not test in India. Now that person who is doing business, okay, gone, his life is gone. Nothing like this should be tested in India. Then, teachers, what is this teachers? Boxes, wooden boxes to preserve the tea leaves. Wooden boxes to preserve the tea leaves. Because the manufacturer of tea outside India wanted tea leaves from India. But the aroma needs to be preserved. Because they give more importance or more money only for the aroma of the tea leaves. Therefore, they will be sending the tea chest. Tea chest. And in the tea chest, because if it is a plastic container or a cardboard box, that smell cannot be preserved. So if it is a wooden crate or a wooden box, the smell can be preserved. So this wooden chest, tea chest will be imported. In that, the tea leaves will be packed and will be exported. Is it clear, pa? Now, that tea chest is imported and exported as such after user. After use, as such without user, after user, after use. We are using it for packing now. Therefore, duty drawback is not available. What if you export it as such without use? Duty drawback is available. Is it clear? So what are the two goods here? Wearing apparel and tea chest. Next, look into 75. 74 is over. 74 is over. Look into 75. Come back to that page where we have started. 75, duty drawback under section 75, page number 28.1. Sir, when 75 is applicable, can you tell me situation? Imported goods are exported after manufacture, correct? Means whatever you have exported is not the same as what you have imported. For this purpose, the rules are notified. Customs Central Excise Duty Drawback Rules 2017. Old rules were there, but with the implementation of GST, they have made these new rules in 2017. Customs Central Excise Duty Drawback Rules 2017. Now, what is the situation when admissible? Imported goods used in manufacture of goods, either finished goods or otherwise said. Don't always think it should be finished goods. It can be processed goods. But the exported goods and imported goods are not same. Just write there in brackets. Exported goods and imported goods are not same. Exported goods and imported goods are not same. Exported goods and imported goods are not same. Are not same. Then, how it can be exported? Sir, what are the three modes in which we can export when it is called as export for 74? Taking it outside India? Second, supply to a SEZ. Third, supply to a foreign going aircraft or vessel. Whether check, these three situations are applicable for 75 also? Same na? For 74 and 75 it is same. So you don't have to remember it separately. Then look into the next related rules. Examples already I gave you. Raw materials are imported, which are converted into finished product, and then it is exported. Situations through which it can be exported. What are the situations here through which it can be exported? See that 74, general export of cargo or baggage or post or courier. For 74, it can be exported as general export of cargo. Like how cargoes and all is exported, like that you can export. Or baggage, you can carry it. Purida, you can carry it. Or you can export it by post or courier. Is it clear here? Whereas in case of 75, one point is excluded. What is that point? Baggage. What is the meaning of baggage? Passenger's luggage. How, sir? Sir, someone is coming from abroad, sir. They will bring something and say if that product is not good, quality is not okay, then they may take it along with them. They would have brought it to give it as a gift here. And maybe here that product is not liked by the person to whom we are thinking to give it as a gift. So that product will be taken back again. Can we get duty drawback with respect to customs duty paid at the time of import? Yes. But this benefit is not applicable under 75 situation. What is that? Imported goods, manufactured or processed and then exported. Either it should be exported as a cargo or like a post or courier, but it cannot be taken along with the person as baggage. Understood or not? That's the difference between 74 and 75 in this case. Time limit? No time limit. No time limit. Sir, after 10 years also I can do? Yes, you do it. After 10 years also. But only thing you have to prove that only imported goods are used in manufacture of exported goods. Prove. If you can prove, you do that. How can I prove, sir? How can I prove? I have to maintain the inventory records so perfectly that I may be making local sales also. I may be making exports also. If I am making local sales, I will not get duty drawback. Yenappa? 75, when you make local sales, you will get duty drawback. When you will get duty drawback? Only when you export it. Correct? So I have to maintain the inventory so perfectly. And that needs to be certified by a chartered accountant or a cost accountant. Then only the duty drawback will be given to me. So that's the reason why usually people will not delay a maximum 1 year or 2 years. They will try to export it. It's an ongoing process. It's an ongoing process. That's why in case of 75, the duty drawback is not on the customs duty paid on import. Listen, listen, please listen. Very, very important point. Sir, I will import, export, import, export, import, export. Maintaining or checking which goods are imported and whether it is used in export or not is a difficult process. So what they did, they changed the system in 75 compared to 74. In 74, duty drawback is given on what? In 74, duty drawback is given on what? 98% of customs duty paid on imports, correct? Whereas in 75, it is not referring to import. Whatever is the FOB value of your export, listen here, whatever is the FOB value of your export, on that a percentage will be given to you as duty drawback. Is it clear? Because it will be a difficult job for them to identify inputs used in the exported goods. Therefore, what they are doing? Take the FOB value of exports. On that FOB value of exports, multiply with a percentage, and that percentage will be given to us duty drawback. Is it clear or not? So therefore, here there is a problem involved. What is that problem? Can you tell me? Can you tell me? Good, very good. Locally procured goods, imported goods, both I will be using in exported goods. On export value, I will be getting duty drawback. Is it clear or not? Many people are enjoying benefit like that. It's a loophole. It's a loophole. What is that here? Can you tell me? 2% of my raw material imported. 98% of my raw material locally procured. Listen, listen. What is the value of the raw material? Say 1 lakh pa. 1 lakh is the value of the raw material. Out of this 1 lakh, 2% is imported. So 2000 is imported. 98% is locally purchased. 98,000 is locally purchased. On import, let's take 30% as the customs duty paid pa. in that 30%, again there will be IGST, etc. Na? No, yeah.
Yes,
so in that 2000, I have to pay basic customs duty. BCD, social welfare surcharge, and IGST. Say it is 200 rupees basic customs duty and 20 rupees social welfare surcharge. 2,220 into say 18% you take. 2,220 into 18%. 400. Okay. 400 is IGST. Understood or not? Sir, are you getting this here?
Yes, sir.
Whereas in case of local purchases, this 2% is import. This 2% is import. This 98% is local purchases. On local purchases, what is the burden or GST that I would have paid? 18%. GST 18%. How much? 98,000 into 18%. 17,640. This 1 lakh rupees worth of goods I will be exporting. Correct? Used in manufacture and which I am converting and I am exporting. Maybe my value addition could be 2 lakhs na? My value addition could be 1 lakh. So the export value could be 2 lakhs. This is my inward supply. This is my inward supply. This is my outward supply. No need to make note. Please listen. This is my outward supply. On 2 lakhs which is exported, I will get duty drawback. Clear or not? Say that duty drawback is 10% of 2 lakhs FOB value I got as a DBK under section 75. So what is the benefit I enjoyed? 20,000. Is it clear? Now, what is my duty incidence, sir? What is my duty incidence? Total on inward supply, what is the incidence? How much pa? Come on, tell me here. 20,000? Eppadi pa? 17,640 plus 200 plus 20 plus 400. How it will go? 20,000 and all. I am only like an idiot, I am asking. Because I don't know how to do calculation. I am weak in maths. You are also or what? How it will go beyond 20,000? 17,640 plus 400 plus 20 plus 200. 18,260 is my total tax incidence. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Now, listen. If it is that 20,000 to compensate this 18,260, okay. Fine. It's okay. But this duty drawback is to compensate, this duty drawback is to compensate only BCD and SWS. IGST, GST, you take as credit, get refund of unutilized credit under GST. Because duty drawback under 75 is only to compensate customs duty and social welfare surcharge. Now, our so-called manufacturers, they literally celebrated. It's a festival season for them. The day when GST came, it was like, go for duty drawback. By default, they will get. By default, they will get. Export value, they will declare in shipping bill. They will select a duty drawback as one of the option. And they will be getting this 20,000 into their account. I got a? Now, they will go to the GST department and they will say, sir, IGST paid on import, sir. And we got this GST on local purchase, sir. Give me refund. Give me refund. And refund sanctioned. Refund sanction. But somewhere, government got a doubt. How this person is getting this much of benefit? And this GST 17,640 also they got as a refund. This 400 also they got as a refund. This 20,000 also they got as a refund. They thought of looting the government itself. Contrary, nah. Government only should loot us. How we can loot them? And therefore, immediately government came out with a notification. If you claim duty drawback under section 75, you will not get any refund of ITC. All these manufacturers and exporters, they got shocked and they went to the High Court. They went to the High Court. How dare is that they can reject this? And High Court said, are you idiots or what? This much benefit you are getting, and what is your tax incidence? Very less. So therefore, they did not give favorable order. They did not give favorable order. They gave the order in favor of the department. And now what department is telling? You claim. Still we are not changing the model. You claim. You claim duty drawback. You claim GST also. We reduce the duty drawback rates. We reduce the duty drawback rates. 10% alla illa. We will not give you. We will give you 4%. We'll give you 4%. Why 4%? Sir, whatever the benefit that you are going to get in duty drawback is only towards basic customs duty. Correct? Ah? Basic customs duty and social welfare surcharge. What is the basic customs duty and social welfare surcharge? 11%. Think. 11%. On what? Inward supply. Easily we'll be making a value addition. Correct? Ah? So on your outward supply, 4% will be given. Understood? On your outward supply, 4% will be given. Then when you will be getting more than your BCD and SWS, only when you increase your value addition. Increase. Now 1 lakh goods you sell for 3 lakhs. You take more money. We don't mind. Is it clear? Are you understanding? Yeah, you are all math students only. Na? 11% on inward supply, 4% on outward supply. When 4% on outward supply will go beyond 11% of inward supply, only when there is a huge value addition. Correct or not? Now, 4% of 2 lakhs, 8,000 you will get as duty drawback. Clear or not? 8,000 you get as duty drawback. And listen here, listen. 8,000 you get as duty drawback. And now whether I can get ITC refund? Yes. After reducing the rates, now GST department started giving the ITC refunds. Clear? When the rates got reduced, when the DBK rates got reduced, GST department start giving the ITC refunds. But in these rules 2017, they kept one rider. If we come to know that the benefit enjoyed by a manufacturer exporter under duty drawback 75 is more than the customs duty incidence, which customs duty incidence? BCD and SWS, then we have right to recover the same under erroneous refund. Understood or not? Clear? Like that they kept. Now in this case, can they do recovery? Yes, they can do recovery. Because what is the customs duty incidence? 220 rupees. For 220 rupees, how much duty drawback they got? 8,000. So far, customs department is silent. So far, they did not. So far, they did not. Like this, many manufacturers are even today enjoying the benefits. So far, they did not. Because the economy is fumbling. So they did not touch. Because if these benefits are given, exporters will be making more exports. So for that reason, they did not touch. But remember, they have power to touch. Clear or not? They have power to touch. And the day when economy starts reviving and when government is falling short of money, they will invoke this and they will say, you got more money in the form of duty drawback, pay it along with interest. Clear, pa? You understood or not? By the time, better, it's a challenger. By the time you clear CA and you go into your job or practice, you will definitely come across this situation. As on today, you may not be experiencing, but definitely will come across this situation that customs department start giving the notices to recover this because that kind of provision they incorporated. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Understood. Now, got the clarity? How duty drawback is given under 75? That is on the FOB value of exports. Is there any time limit to export? No. And coverage of duty, what coverage?
BCD
and SWS. So whatever duty drawback they give, when they are creating the trade, in their mind they keep which as the base? BCD and social welfare surcharge and legacy taxes. Legacy taxes, which are legacy taxes? Excise duty, we had na? So that excise duty will be taken into account. Please see. Customs, excise duty is only refunded. Sir, excise duty is still there, sir? Yes. CVD. CVD 3 subsection 1 and SAD 3 subsection 5. On which? CVD 3 subsection 1, SAD 3 subsection 1 which? Alcohol, tobacco products, petroleum products. Still we have, na? Special customs duties are covered under duty drawback. That is, which means whether we get even benefit of ADD, safeguard duty, and anti-dumping duty, anti-subsidy duty, yes, all those are there. All those are there. But what is excluded? IGST and GST components. Sir, can I take ITC on that? Take. See the note. Can avail ITC of IGST and claim refund. ITC refund is there, na? There you can claim the refund. Understood or not? Then, look into rates of duty drawback. Rule 3, AIR, all industry rate, which is a general rate, pa. Depending upon the product you are exporting, HSN code, there will be a rate. Duty drawback schedule is available in this dgft.gov.in, Direct Rate General of Foreign Trade, DGFT website, dgft.gov.in, you can get the duty drawback rates. So if you click on like duty drawback schedule, it will come. It will be like a PDF containing lot of HSN numbers with the duty drawback rates. Depending upon the product you are exporting, its HSN, you can find the duty drawback rate. That rate is known as AIR, all industry rate. Look into the footnote. Point number 4. As per rule 4, CG may revise amount or rates determined under rule 3. Highlight that. What is it? When they will do revision? If benefit under 75 greater than customs duty incidence, correct? Huh? Customs duty incidence on import. If benefit under section 75 is greater than customs duty incidence on import. Just now we discussed, na? Sir, can someone call the admin, sir? Vinay? Water bottle. Then, see this, rule 6, brand rate. Brand rate refers to a situation where you are exporting a product, but that product, there is no rate specified. You are exporting a product, but that product itself, HSN, its HSN is not there in the list. So you don't have the duty drawback rate. Then you can make an application for brand rate. See that. When no all industry rate is fixed in the duty drawback schedule, then it is brand rate. Okay? Then look into the footnote number 5. Thanks. Exporter, how should he apply for the brand rate? Please see, pa. There is an application form in which he need to submit within 3 months from let export order. Somewhere we discussed this 3 months. 74 duty drawback claim, 3 months plus 3 months by ACDC. Clear or not? Plus 3 months by ACDC with a fee of 1% of FOB or 1000, whichever is lower. Plus 6 months by commissioner. Next page, continuation footnote. 6 months by commissioner with a fee of 2% or FOB, 2% of FOB or 2000, whichever is lower. This time limit is same as 74 time limit, correct? Huh? Sir, fees we will remember, sir. That's not a problem. Time limit you try to remember. 3 months plus 3 months by ACDC plus 6 months by commissioner. Fees ACDC, 1% of FOB or 1000, whichever is lower. Appa maximum 1000, correct? Napa? And commissioner? 2% of FOB or 2000, whichever is lower. So in all practical cases, it will be 1000, 2000, correct? Yes, sir. No, yeah. When 1% of FOB should be less than 1000, means the value of the goods which is exported is somewhere 90,000, 80,000, like that. Correct, appa? Usually exports value will not be that much less here. Exports will be higher. So maximum 1000 rupees, 2000 rupees. That is the application fee. Then next, special brand rate. Look into the next. Sir, what are the 3 rates of duty drawback under 75? All industry rate, brand rate, special brand rate. All industry rate means there is a duty drawback schedule and they will be notifying the rate. That is all industry rate. Brand rate, when there is no rate prescribed, no rate prescribed against the product, then it is known as brand rate. We need to make an application for that. Special brand rate, when they notified all industry rate and the duty drawback as per all industry rate is less than, then they have notified all industry rate and the duty drawback as per all industry rate is less than 80% of the customs duty incidence. Clear pa? I paid 1 lakh as customs duty. Which customs duty? BCD, SWS. Okay, I paid 1 lakh as customs duty, but I got duty drawback which is 75,000. Now can I go for special brand rate? Yes, read. When DBK under all industry rate is less than 80% of the actual duties or tax incidents. And for this also we need to make an application, pa. But remember one important point, that is once you go for AIR, you can never go for SBR, which means what? Before going to AIR, do your homework. What homework? Check how much you will get as per AIR. If it is less than 80% of the customs duty, don't go for AIR. Then directly go for SBR. Look into that footnote 6.6. Exporter shall apply for fixation of SBR. He is not entitled to claim AIR and then apply for SBR. He is not entitled to claim AIR and then apply for SBR. You understood? Means what? Directly he need to go for SBR. Clear, yaar? But until that time, that special brand rate is notified, he may ask for some provisional duty drawback. Continue. Till fixation of SBR, exporter may request for grant of duty drawback on provisional basis. Time limit for application of SBR is same as the time limit for application of brand rate. Understood? Then, look into realization of forex. Sir, is realization of forex a condition under 74? No, but it is a condition under section 75. And what will happen if the forex is not realized? What will happen if the forex is not realized? Then whatever duty drawback we got, that we need to pay along with interest at the rate of 15% per annum. Remember, in customs, every place the rate of interest is 15% per annum. In customs, if we need to pay interest, it's always 15% per annum. Like how in GST, 18% per annum. So everywhere, wherever we need to pay interest, that is 15% per annum. Where they give us interest, that is 6% per annum. Is it clear? So what is the interest here? 15% per annum. From the date when you have got the duty drawback till the date you repay that duty drawback. And who will prescribe the time limit for realization of foreign exchange? RBI. RBI will fix the time limit for realization of foreign exchange. Within that time limit fixed by RBI, we need to. And how RBI will fix? On the basis of what? FEMA. Is it clear here? On the basis of what? FEMA. And because even in FEMA, they gave a link to RBI only. So RBI from time to time will be fixing the time limit for bringing the foreign currency, okay? So that time limit should be followed. But we don't have any time limit under customs. Clear air? See that. Realization of forex is must. If exporter fails to realize forex within the time allowed under FEMA, then DBK paid becomes recoverable with interest at the rate of 15% per annum from the date of DBK till the date of recovery of duty drawback. Understood? Then pa. Mandatory prohibition. First 2 points, same as what we have in 74. What is that first point? DBK less than 50, not allowed. And market value of the export goods is less than the amount of duty drawback, not allowed. Now I have given one example in the context of 75. See there. Sir, when in the context of 75 it will happen that way, wherein you have declared more value of the export goods. In order to get more incentive, you have declared more FOB value. Please see here. Imported goods value could be something. And irrespective of that imported value of the goods, you will get duty drawback under 75, correct? So what is the market value of the exported goods? 30,000. What is the FOB value declared? 44 lakhs. And on that 4 lakhs, 10% duty drawback is 40,000. So what you have done? You inflated the export value, correct or not?
Yes, sir.
Sir, there can be a value of export more than the local sale price, possible. There could be the value of export more than the local sale price. That's where handicrafts are being sold at a higher price. You have this pot, now pot to drink water. And how much we pay for it? 50 rupees or 100 rupees, correct? Whereas that is priced at $10. That is priced at $10 in the export market, which means it is 650 to 700 rupees. That is the range. You understood? So like that, lot of handmade goods, handicrafts, etc. At local market it is cheaper, but at international market it is higher. That's okay, fine. But not for all goods. Not for all goods, you cannot inflate it like this. You cannot inflate it like this, which means there is something fishy. That's why they are not giving duty drawback. Understood or not? Then rule 9, next to prohibition, as per rule 9, maximum duty drawback is 33.33% of the market price of the exported goods. What is this? Look into the example. Export price is 1 lakh. Indian market value is 50. Yes, normal. That inflation is normal. If you are selling at 10 rupees here, export is 20 rupees. That's normal. Two times, three times. That's normal, usually normal. Two times only, not three times only. Two times is normal. So, okay, fine. But what is the all industry rate? 30% of FOB. 30% of FOB means 30,000. But what is the 1/3 of the market value of the exported goods? 1/3 of the market value of the exported goods, 16,667. So maximum duty drawback that you will get will be 16,667. Can you tell me this four, three prohibitions? Number one, DBK less than 50, not allowed. If the amount of DBK is less than or more than? More than market value of the exported goods. Or you can remember in a reverse. Market value of the exported goods less than the amount of duty drawback, not allowed. Maximum duty drawback that is allowed is 1/3 of the market price. Then, no DBK allowed if value of export goods is less than the value of imported materials used therein. Can you explain what does it mean? Negative value addition, correct? Export value is less than import value. There is a negative value addition. Means whatever currency that is going from India is more than what is coming into India. In that case, no incentive is given to you. Understood? No DBK allowed if value of export goods is less than the value of imported materials used therein. Is it clear? But how they will know, sir? They will not know. But during audit, they will know. They will not know at the time of export, but during audit they will know, because you have to tell what quantity of the goods are used for export na. So during that time they will know, they will recover the duty drawback. No DBK allowed if value of export goods is less than the value of imported materials used therein. You understood this point? Means negative value addition, no duty drawback. Look into another point, continuation. No DBK allowed if value of export goods not more than the notified percentage of the value of imported materials used. In some cases, they will tell the value addition percentage. Means you need to achieve that value addition percentage. Otherwise, duty drawback is not given. Notified goods, you have to achieve the value addition. What is notified? Value addition is notified. You have to achieve that value addition. Other than those notified goods, you have to achieve positive value addition. Is it clear here?
Yes, sir.
Now, listen. Sir, exactly export value is equal to import value, sir. And there is no notified value addition. Whether I get duty drawback? Check. Exactly the export value is equal to the import value. 75 only. 75 only, it is not 74. 75 only. Will I get duty drawback? Yes. What is the word that is used? Value less than. Export value less than import value. Then only no duty drawback. What if it is equal to duty drawback? Clear or not? Then next. Notified 10%. I achieved 10%. value addition notified 10% pa, I achieved 10% pa. Now will I get duty drawback? See there, not more than, so I should achieve more, exactly if I achieve will not get duty drawback, is it clear? Based on that only I have given illustration in the next page, see that. Import value 100, export value 102, notified value addition nothing is there. Whether there is a positive value addition, yes. Whether DBK available, yes. 100, 100, no notified value addition, will I get duty drawback, yes. 199, no, value addition not notified, but it is negative, so I will not get duty drawback, is it clear? Then 100, 107, 7% is the value addition, but the notified is 10%, I will not get duty drawback. And 100, 110, I achieved 10%, notified is also 10%, then also I will not get duty drawback. Why? Because I should achieve more than the notified percentage. 100 and 111, what I have achieved is 11, what is notified is 10, so I got more than that, whatever is notified, therefore I will get duty drawback, understood? Then discretionary prohibition, same as 74. Same as 74. What is same as 74? If the goods are likely to be smuggled back to India, in that case, duty drawback may not be given. So this is discretionary, sir. At whose discretion? Central government. But so far what we have seen is mandatory prohibition. Identity satisfaction, whether we need to prove to the officer that exported goods and imported goods are same, not required. Because in 75, always export goods is different from the imported goods. Now, is there any application for the purpose of 75? Listen, if you want AIR, na, listen, pa, please, if you want AIR, there are three rates, AIR, brand rate, special brand rate. If you want AIR, there is no separate application. Pa. Whatever shipping bill that you file, in that itself option will be available. You select that option whether you want duty drawback or not. If you select the option, you will get duty drawback as per AIR. If you are not selecting the option, you will not get duty drawback. You have to proceed under brand rate, special brand rate. Understood? See there. There is no separate form for DBK claim. Shipping bill or bill of export shall be deemed to be claimed for DBK. In which case? In case of AIR, all industry rate. In case of all industry rate, that shipping bill or bill of export itself, the shipping bill or bill of export itself is sufficient. Sir, this non-availability of duty drawback is applicable in case of 75 wearing apparel, teachers, no, that is not applicable for 75, that's applicable only for 74, subsection 2. Then, look into this section 75, proviso to rule 3. I told you, na, they can reduce, read that. What is it? Come on here. That is, if you have not paid customs duty on the entire inputs, your purchases entirely is not imported, means part are domestic. Now, they may reduce, the duty drawback admissible on the said goods shall be reduced by taking into account the lesser duty paid or the rebate, refund or credit obtained. Taking into that into account, they may reduce it. They shall reduce it if you have enjoyed more benefit. Clear? So far, they have not invoked this proviso to rule 3, but they can invoke at any point of time. Interest on DBK. Suppose if there is in, you have made application for DBK, within 1 month you did not get, how much interest they will pay? 6%. You unnecessarily got DBK, erroneously. Now they are recovering. Now? 18%. Good, 15%. Look into this illustration on 74 subsection 2. Sir, import of goods, customs duty paid is 1 lakh. Motor car by Mr. A for personal use. First category or second category? First category. Motor car, don't see further. Motor car, don't see further. First category. After use of 5 months. 5 months means how many quarters? 2 quarters. So 2 into 4, 8%. So if you take out 8%, 100 minus 8, 92%, you will get duty drawback. After use of 1 year, 5 months. For 1 full year, 16. Second year, 2 quarters. That is 6. 6. So therefore, 16 plus 6, 22%. So 100 minus 22, 78%. After use of 2 years and 5 months, first year, 16. Second full year, 12. And in the third year, 5 months means 2.5, 2.5, 5. So add that. 33, 100 minus 33, 67%. What if it is motor car by A Limited? Same. Sir, motor car, the same treatment. Computer by Mr. A for personal use, then also it will be same. What if computer is imported by A Limited? Second category. Depending upon the period of use, so we will get duty drawback. First, 5 months, it comes in which slab? 3 to 6. 3 to 6 means second na? For second it is 85. Is it clear here? Yes, then 1 year, 5 months means how many months? 17 months. Last slab, 15 to 18, that is 60%. 60%. 2 years, 5 months, beyond 18 months, you will not get duty drawback. IGST refund not allowed to exporters after claiming benefit of higher duty drawback rate. This I discuss with you. That is, initially, until the time they reduce the duty drawback, please listen, pa. Initially, until the time they reduce the duty drawback, if you have claimed a higher rate of duty drawback, IGST refund you will not get. Is it clear? Refund of unutilized rate is you can go under GST, na? That benefit you will not get. So, I gave you an example, right? This example, that only I have given here. Consider this illustration. A Limited imported goods worth rupees 10 lakhs, chargeable to BCD at 10%, IGST 12%, and purchased inputs and input services worth rupees 8 lakhs, excluding GST at 18%, which are used in manufacture of finished goods and exported to Australia. FOB value of exports is 40 lakhs. The notified DBK rate under section 75 for such product is 10% of FOB. Now, first we will see what are the duty burdens or tax burden on inward supplies. First, they are importing. Na? What is the FOB value of import? 10 lakhs. So, on that basic customs duty 10%, 1 lakh. And social welfare surcharge 10,000. IGST 10 lakhs plus 1 lakh 10,000, that is 11 lakh 10,000 into 12%, 1 lakh 33,200. So total customs duty paid on import is 2 lakh 43,200. Understood that? Plus they purchased locally inputs, na? And what is its worth? 8 lakhs. On that GST 18%, 1 lakh 44. So total duty or tax incidence is 3 lakh 87,200. Now what is the FOB value of exports? 40 lakhs. On 40 lakhs, what is the duty drawback rate? 10%. So 40 lakhs into 10%, 4 lakhs. Plus refund of IGST paid on imports also you will claim. 1,33,200. Refund of GST paid on inward supply, 1,44,000. So total benefit accrued on export is 6,77,200. Okay. Now continue to the next. From the above illustration, it is clear that A Limited enjoys more benefit than its actual duty or tax incidence. Therefore, refund of IGST paid on imports is rejected. Understood, pa? During which period, sir? During which period? Higher duty drawback rate period. Higher duty drawback rate. Sir, I told you initially there was higher duty drawback rate. At that time, it was rejected. But now it will be rejected, huh? No. When you claim duty drawback during the lower duty drawback rate period, then will the IGST on refund of ITC, will it be rejected? No. Write that here. Note. if DBK claimed under lower DBK rates, if DBK claimed under lower DBK rates, then refund of ITC with respect to IGST or GST paid shall not be rejected. If DBK claimed under lower DBK rates, then refund of ITC with respect to IGST or GST paid shall not be rejected. However, Proviso to Rule 3 enables Customs Department to recover excess DBK claimed. Enappa? However, Proviso to Rule 3 enables Customs Department to recover excess DBK claimed. Okay, here. Then we completed 74 and 75. The next area is section 26A, refund of import duty in certain cases. See this. You need a break? Can I continue this concept and then give you break? So I'll give you break at 3:15. Is it okay? Hardly 20 minutes. We started at 1:10 only here. Say this. I sent a message that there is no lunch break because we are starting at 1 o'clock. Have you seen that? In Telegram, I have posted in that group. You are not there, huh? No internet connection, huh? Sorry, one more day, so I am not speaking anything. See this. Section 26A always should be compared with Section 74 because 26A also we get a benefit, like imported goods are exported. Imported goods are exported after clearance. Imported goods means we have cleared it for home consumption and then exported due to some reasons. We get 100% of the customs duty paid as refund. Clear? Imported goods cleared, we paid customs duty, and then when you are exporting for certain reasons, you get 100% of the customs duty paid as refund. So whereas 26A is more powerful than 74 subsection 1, correct? Yes, 74 subsection only 98%. But the 26A, you get 100%. So therefore, we need to compare while preparing itself, while discussing this itself, as to how 26A is superior over 74 subsection 1. If 26A fails also, not a worry. We have 74 subsection 1. Understood? See that. Where on importation of any goods, 74 is also for any goods, correct? Capable of being easily identified as such. For 74 also, identification is required. Any duty has been paid on clearance of such goods. For 74 subsection 1 also, we will pay customs duty and we will clear. Such duty shall be refunded to the person. What is the meaning of such duty? 100%. Such duty means 100%. We will get as refund. 100% refund. By whom or on whose behalf it was paid? If, very, very important. Reasons. The goods are found to be defective. What's the first reason here? Goods are found to be defective. defective or otherwise not in conformity with the specifications. First point, defective. Second point, not in conformity with the specifications agreed upon between the importer and supplier of goods. So in these two cases only, what are the two cases? Defective or not in conformity with the specifications. Provided that the goods have not been worked, repaired or used. Even 74 subsection 1 also, it should not be used. It should not be used after importation, except where such use was indispensable to discover the defects. 74 also same. 74 subsection 1 also same. That is, to identify the defects, you may open and see. That does not mean use. Use means commercial use. Clear? Use means commercial use. Then, B. The goods are identified to the satisfaction of ACDC. Same, 74 subsection 1. The importer does not claim duty drawback under the provisions of the Act, which means section 74 subsection 1 and section 26A are mutually exclusive. Why am I comparing with 74 subsection 1? Why should not I compare with 74 subsection 2? Used. But here it says that it should not be used. Why can't I compare with 75 different product? But here it should be the same product. So therefore I need to compare only with 74 subsection 1. Next. The goods are exported or importer relinquishes his title to the goods or abandon them to the customs or such goods are destroyed. See here, sir, in case of 74 subsection 1, I should export outside India, supply to SEZ or sell it to foreign going vessel or aircraft. But here, I can export or I can relinquish the title. What is the meaning of relinquishing the title? I don't want these goods. Relinquishing the title or destroying the goods. You understood? Got the difference here? So this is the place where there is a difference between 74 and 26A. This is the difference. Difference between 74 subsection 1 and 26A. We don't have this in 74 subsection 1. 74 subsection 1 says what? Either you export it or sell it to a SEZ or sell it to a foreign going vessel or aircraft. But here it is either you export. Export means what? Outside India. Or you destroy it. Or you relinquish the title. In such manner as may be prescribed. And what is the time limit? 30 days. Sir, here also there is a difference. Correct? See that, 30 days, and wait, 30 days, provided the period of 30 days may be extended for a further period of 3 months. So here also there is a difference. Difference between 74 subsection 1 and 26A. Difference between 74 subsection 1 and 26A. Okay, here. There it is. Inna 3 plus. When are the 3 plus 3 plus? What is the time limit within which I should export? 2 years. 2 years. Correct? Which can be further extended for a period. Correct? CBIC. But here it is 30 days plus 3 months. Where we discuss that? That is for filing application, not for export. Correct? Then, application for refund shall be made before the expiry of 6 months. There. Now tell. 3 plus 3 plus 6. Here it is only 6 months. No refund shall be allowed in respect of perishable goods and goods which have exceeded their shelf life. Sir, this is only for the defective goods or not conforming to the specification, not in case of perishable goods. Clear? Which means you have to clear it within 10 days. You clear it after 10 days. Life is over. Now you will not get benefit under 26A, but you can get benefit under 74 subsection 1. But benefit available, because anywhere in 74 subsection 1 we have this? We have anything like this? No. But benefit under section 74 subsection 1 available if market value greater than, correct? Huh? Market value of export goods greater than amount of DBK. Napa? Means some value will be there now for that. It may have exceeded the shelf life or it may be perishable. Some value may be there. If some value is there, check. Suppose if it is less, you will not get benefit under 74 subsection 1 also. Are you getting this? CBIC may specify any other condition subject to which refund may be allowed. You understood 26AR? Now, let's see some case studies based on 74 subsection 1 and 26A. Here we need to apply both 74 subsection 1 and 26A, and you need to write. Discuss the admissibility of duty drawback under section 74 for the following situations where goods are imported to Mumbai port and the customs duty paid on import is rupees 1 lakh. A Limited imported laptops from Lenovo Incorporation for the purpose of trading, and the said laptops imported are sold to foreign buyers at a profit. Whether we get 26A? Whether we get 26A? Why you will not get 26A? Is it defective?
No.
Is it not conforming to the specifications?
No.
If it is the case, then how you can sell? Correct? Huh? If it is the case, how you can sell? So therefore, section 26A is not applicable. Right there. Note. Section 26A not applicable. Not applicable as the goods are not defective and conforming to specifications. Correct, Appa? It should not conform to the specification. If it conforms to the specifications, then no benefit under 26A. But 74 subsection 1 is available. Yes, imported goods are exported, yes or no?
Yes, sir.
As such or not?
Yes, sir.
With use or without use?
No.
How you can sell? How you can sell if it is with use? Correct. Trader, you are a trader.
Yes,
how you can sell with use? So it is without use. So the benefit under 74 subsection 1, how much? 98% of customs duty paid on import. What is the customs duty paid on import? 1 lakh. 1 lakh into 98%, 98,000. Then, second, A Limited imported laptops from Lenovo Incorporation for the purpose of use by its employees, and after use for 6 months they were sold to foreign buyers at a loss. Note, section 26A not applicable. Section 26A not applicable. Why? I'll write different reason. As the goods are exported after use. As the goods are exported after use. Even you can write defective, that also you can write. Can we get benefit under 74? Yes or no? 74, yes. Which section? Subsection 1, subsection 2. Subsection 2, it is used. And for how many months it is used? 6 months. Means it comes in the second slab. 3 to 6 months. How much will be the duty drawback?
85%.
So what is the customs duty paid? 1 lakh. 1 lakh into 85%? 85,000. Understood? Then third, A Limited imported laptops from Lenovo Incorporation for the purpose of trading, and the said laptops imported or sold to various buyers in India at a profit. 26A also not applicable. 74 subsection 1 also not applicable. Correct? Huh? Duty drawback is available only when imported goods are exported. In the present case, as goods are not exported, duty drawback not available. Note, 26A is also not applicable. Section 26A not applicable. 26A not applicable. What if it is sold to SEZ? 74 subsection 1 applicable, 26A is not applicable. What if it is sold to foreign going vessel or aircraft? Then also 74 subsection 1 applicable, 26A is not applicable. Correct? Laptops can be sold. Something for use in that foreign going vessel or aircraft. See fourth. Mr. A, read that air. Read that and tell me. Twenty-six A possible? Mr. A imported laptops from Lenovo Incorporation for the purpose of personal use, and the importer cleared the consignment for home consumption. When he tried to run it, it malfunctioned. He is not using it. Checking will not be considered as use. 26A possible. Upon contacting the supplier, supplier asked him to send back the laptop and promised to send another laptop in replacement. Now, 74 subsection 1 is also applicable. 26A is also applicable. So importer can choose between these two benefits depending upon the conditions. Correct?
Yes, sir.
That is, suppose if time limit is there, he can go for 26A. If time limit is not there, he can go for 74 subsection 1. Is it clear? But both sections are applicable? Yes. Right there. Either 98% of customs duty paid, either 98% of customs duty paid can be claimed as DBK, can be claimed as DBK under section 74 subsection 1, 74 subsection 1, or 100% of customs duty paid, or 100% of customs duty paid can be claimed as refund, can be claimed as refund under section 26A, depending upon the conditions, depending upon the conditions under both the sections, depending upon the conditions under both the sections. I'll tell you, there is a problem in 74 subsection 1. That is, as the laptop is defective, its market value is less than the amount of duty drawback. That situation may come. If that comes, then 74 subsection 1 is not possible, but 26A is possible. Clear here?
Sir, suppose there is a warranty, international warranty, suppose there is an international warranty, it is as good as getting a replacement, so market value.
That's different here. That is like indemnity. There is a warranty, you will be getting it. That's a different story. But which product you are exporting, that product's market value we need to see. Na. Then fifth one, and one more point. One more point. What if the new laptop is brought as replacement? Normal customs duty payable on import of new laptop. Right there. Note. Normal customs duty payable on import of new laptop. On import of new laptop. But sir, remember, when you send a product from here, if the same product is coming back, you don't have to pay any customs duty at the time of import. Is it clear? When you send a product and the same product is coming back, you don't have to pay customs duty, but a different product is coming na. Then 5, A Limited imported consignment of LED lights from China and the purpose of import is for trading in India. Importer submitted the bill of entry and cleared for home consumption. Upon checking, LED was found to be defective. A Limited contacted the seller and the seller got the consignment tested in India through its agency in India. Agency clarified that concerned consignment is defective. Seller asked the importer to destroy the consignment as sending it back would involve unnecessary cost. Seller promises to send the fresh consignment in replacement. 26A. Only 26A, right there. DBK under section 74, subsection 1. DBK under section 74, subsection 1, not applicable. DBK under section 74, subsection 1, not applicable. Why? As the goods are not, as the said goods are not exported. Right. As the said goods are not exported. As the said goods are not exported. As the said goods are not exported. However, refund under section 26A. However, refund under section 26A can be claimed. However, refund under section 26A can be claimed by the importer if the goods are destroyed within 30 days or further extended time limit of 3 months from the date of import. Correct? Am I right here? From the date of import means date of clearance. Huh? Date of 3 months from the date of import of goods for home consumption. It is clearance. From the date of import means here clearance. From the date of import means clearance. Okay. Look into two past exam questions. Case study number 1. An exporter exported 2000 pairs of leather shoes at 750 per pair. All industry rate of duty drawback is fixed on average basis, that is 11% of FOB, subject to a maximum of 80 rupees per pair. The exporter found that the actual duty paid on inputs was 1,95,000. He has approached you as a consultant to apply under Rule 7 of duty drawback rules for fixation of special brand rate. Advise him suitably. What will be your answer if he has already made an application for DBK under Rule 3? First, whether Rule 7 is applicable or not, we will see. What is Rule 7? Special brand rate. Special brand rate. When you can go for special brand rate? When DBK as per all industry rate is less than 80% of the customs duty incidence. Correct? Huh? Now, first calculate DBK as per AIR. Right there. DBK as per AIR. DBK as per AIR equals to 2000 into 80 or 2000 into 750 into 11%, whichever is lower. Am I right? Check the question. 11% of FOB subject to a maximum of 80 per pair. Clear? 11% of FOB subject to a maximum of 80 per pair means whichever is lower. And what is FOB? 2000 pairs into 750 per pair. That is FOB. This 2000 into 750 is known as FOB. FOB into 11%. or 2000 pairs into 80, whichever is lower, equals to 1,60,000 or 1,65,000, whichever is lower, that equals to rupees 1,60,000. What is the customs duty incidence? Customs duty incidence. While taking customs duty incidence, we need to exclude incidence. While taking customs duty incidence, we need to exclude IGST. But we don't have the information here, correct? Huh? How much it is? 1,95,000. What is the percentage of DBK over customs duty incidence? What is the percentage of DBK over customs duty incidence? 1,60,000 divided by 1,95,000 into 100 equals to 82.05%. So what is the conclusion you can arrive? What is the conclusion that we can arrive? As DBK under AIR is not less than 80% of customs duty incidence, comma, application for special brand rate cannot be made. Application for SBR, special brand rate, cannot be made. Understood? Then, note, what is it? If application for AIR is made under Rule 3, comma, application for SBR under Rule 7 cannot be made even if DBK under AIR is less than 80% of customs duty incidence. Is it clear here? Then look into second. Calculate the amount of duty drawback admissible under Section 74 of the Customs Act in the following cases. Salman imported a motor car for his personal purpose, maybe to hit and run, and paid rupees 4,50,000 as import duty. The car is re-exported after use for 6 months and 20 days. What will be your answer if the car is re-exported immediately without bringing it into use? First, car, 74 subsection, 1, na? No, 2. The car is re-exported after use for 6 months. So therefore, 74 subsection, 2. In that first category. So how many months he used? 6 months means 2 quarters. So 8%. So 100 minus 8, 92% will be the duty drawback. Check the answer. 6 months, huh? 6 months and 20 days. So 3 quarters. So 12%. 100 minus 12, 88%. So 4,50,000 into 88%. What will be your answer if car is re-exported immediately without bringing it into use? 74 subsection 1 and 98% of 4,50,000. Second, Nisha imported wearing apparel and paid 50,000 as import duty. As she did not like the apparel, these are re-exported after using it for 20 days. No duty drawback. 74 subsection 2, used. No duty drawback. What will your answer if wearing apparel is re-exported immediately without put to use? 98% of the customs duty paid on import. Third, Supertech Limited imported 10 computer systems paying customs duty of rupees 50 lakhs. Due to some technical problems, the computer systems were returned to the foreign suppliers after 2 months without using them at all. Without using them at all. So 98%. Correct? And 26A is also possible. I think they did not ask as per 26A. They are giving only 74. But if you want, you can write that. If you want, you can write that. Then, fourth one. XYZ Limited exported 1,000 kgs of metal of FOB value of 1 lakh. Rate of duty drawback on such export is 60 per kg. Market price of the goods is 40,000. Sir, market value is less than the duty drawback. How much is the duty drawback? 1,000 into 60, 60,000. But market value of the goods is less than the amount of duty drawback. So no duty drawback. Five, Meenakshi imported a music player from Dubai and paid 12,000 as import duty. She used it for 4 months, but re-export the same after 4 months. Case A, used for personal, and case B, used for other than personal purpose. Suppose if she used for personal purpose, category one, what is that? 4% for every quarter or part thereof. 4 months na, 4 months means 2 quarters, so 8%, 92%. What if it is used for other than personal purpose? How many months? 4 months means which slab? 3 to 6. 3 to 6 means 85%. Is it clear here? So with this, duty drawback is over. We'll take a break. Sir, 10 minutes is enough?
Yes, sir.
Enough? Okay. Take 15 minutes. But sharp, come, because I'll be starting with a new topic, that is baggage rules.